The September 18th meeting of the Bay City City Commission will come to order. The city clerk will give the invocation, which will be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance. Please rise.
Almighty God, send us all those who will offer in the city the spirit of wisdom, charity, and justice, that they may faithfully serve in their offices to promote the well-being of all people.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Will the clerk please call the roll?
Commissioner Lockett.
Here.
Rivet.
Here.
Ronnie.
Yes.
Brunner.
Here.
Booker.
Here.
Gerard.
Here.
Lipsey.
Here.
Clements.
Here.
Morris.
Here.
Batavera.
I'm present. So we have everyone here in attendance, so we have one. The next item. And we have nothing tonight. Now we are at the adoption of the agenda. Board members of the commission wish to add an item to the agenda. Commissioner Gerard.
Yes, I have one item. I'll share my desk. Commissioner Gerard, whereas Bay City Compensation Commission is required by city charter to meet in every odd number of year and makes out a determination for the mayor and city commissioners. And whereas the Bay City Compensation Commission met on September 7th, 2023 to discuss salary of mayor and city commissioners. And whereas the Compensation Commission recommended to increase the mayor's salary from $2,900 to $9,000 and commissioner's salary to $8,000 from $7,500. Now, therefore, we resolve that the Bay City Commission rejects the determination of salaries dated September 7th, 2023. Be it further resolved that per the city charter, the existing salary will prevail.
Is there a motion? Any objections to receiving this? Would be a great deal. Seeing none. This will be on the agenda. Is there anyone? Commissioner Murray?
Yes. I have a resolution for Commissioner Andre Murray of the discharge mortgages dated 2010 to 2022 and all excessive mortgages in the future, grants funded by the CDBG, Community Development Block Grants, and the mortgages written by Bay Area Housing and Bay Area Housing Incorporated and of the Bay City affiliate in the CDBG. Whereas the City of Bay City recognizes that the community at large, and especially low-income residents, have many diverse needs for social housing, education, and other services. And whereas the City of Bay City Community Development Department are working closely with our city manager and committed to providing decent and affordable housing for persons of lower to moderate income levels. Whereas the City of Bay City is committed to effectively serving the community, reference that on 2010 through 2022, Community Development had authorized or her designee to apply for accept assistance of project located in lower to moderate neighborhoods for the purpose of obtaining financing and grants from HUD and all federal government funding to provide for the purpose of rehabilitation, construction, etc. of projects. The City of Bay City being affiliation of Bay Area Housing and Bay Area Housing Incorporated. Now, therefore, be it resolved as follows, that the commission further move to authorize the Community Development Department head or her designee to execute any or all documents required by the City of Bay City, including without limitation, the loan agreement, the note, the deeds, conditions and restrictions, the disclosure statements, and all other documents to the mortgagees to be dismissed, discharged, dated from 2010 through 2022, and any note to be written excessive excessive notes of 20-year mortgages in the future. Be it further resolved as follows, that the City of Bay City Commission further authorize the Bay City Community Development in or designee to perform all acts and powers in the authority of Bay City, Michigan. The City of Bay City on this day, at which a quorum is here present, would please, please think of this for the people of the mortgages that were signed for furnaces and these type of things for 20-year mortgages. Please, please think about this. Is there a motion or any objection? So it will go on the regular agenda. Anyone else? You're now in consent. Please take the roll. Any motion?
Move to adopt the agenda.
Second, Commissioner Gerard.
Second.
Commissioner Becker.
Yes.
Rivet.
Yes.
Rooney.
Yes.
Brunner.
Yes.
Hilliker.
Yes.
Gerard.
Yes.
Kuzbetsky.
Yes.
Clements.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
Reyes.
The agenda has been adopted. Now the consent agenda. Is there a specific?
That's all it is. I'm sorry, I apologize for the sidebar. I missed what was happening.
Okay, now it's the consent agenda. Do any members of the commission wish to make a change to the consent agenda? Seeing none, then folks in the audience will have an opportunity to come to the podium, write your name and address on the sign-in sheet, and you will have 5 minutes to speak. Things that are on the consent agenda. So if you want, would you please come up? So is there a motion, commissioners, on the consent agenda? Commissioner Brunner?
Move to approve the consent agenda.
Is there a second? Commissioner Clements?
Second.
Would the clerk please call the roll on the action of the consent agenda?
Commissioner Rivet? Commissioner Brunner?
Yes.
Brunner?
Yes.
Hilliker?
Yes.
Gerard?
Yes.
Kuzbetsky?
Yes.
Clements?
Yes.
Morris?
Yes.
Becker?
Yes.
Reyes?
The recommendations as listed on the consent agenda have been approved. Now, we are in the session of the business remarks of the mayor and the commission. And I do just want to make a few comments. I would like to see this commission follow the compensation commission who have been appointed. There's 3 former commissioners who are on. Also, we didn't have an increase 2 years ago when it was brought to us again. And I guess it kind of bothers me. Not that we don't think we get paid enough, because we don't expect to be paid any more than any other city around. But I just worry that if we keep denying the compensation commission, once again, who we have appointed, that there won't be one and that we're gonna lose. We also have, I think, 6 people leaving in the year in December of 2024. And sometimes when people see
next appointments. And I just wanted to put my two cents in, so I'm done. Any commissioners want to speak? Commissioner Clements?
Yes, thank you. City manager, regarding it passed on the consent agenda, resolution 14, the sidewalk cafes on 600 block by September 27th. How are they notified? By letter, in person, phone call, email?
We'll probably do all of the above, just to make sure that they get the message. We'll send a letter, but we also will make some type of communication to them.
Okay.
We'll do that. We'll start doing that by tomorrow.
Thank you. And then next, to the city manager, there's a camper parked on North Elk Street. It's been there probably going on 2 weeks now. It has for sale signs on it. It's across from 205 North Elk between West Vermont and West Ohio. And then the next thing, I did send an email to you today, though I also included the commissioner, it's Becky. Midland Street area, the parking, which is a good problem to have, but I think we all know we need more parking, so whatever we can do to as quickly as possible for that grass lot by the marina, if we can make that parking lot, it would be awesome. And then lastly, I'm with the mayor on the compensation commission. Thank you.
Commissioner.
The other thing I have is after a lot of delay, we have the goal setting meeting finally on the books. It's scheduled, it's coming on October 23rd, save the date for it. We'll actually get it done. Had to wrangle some things and then I disappeared for a while and I kind of fell in the back burner, but we're there, we're getting the goals, we're getting them done, we're getting squared away. So October 23rd, are we doing 5:30 or 6?
I think we decided 5:30.
5:30 on October 23rd.
And I believe I sent that calendar to everybody since I did. Okay.
Thank you. That's all.
Thank you. So, anyone else? Commissioner Gerard?
Just real quickly, I did introduce the resolution to reject. Each commissioner can voice their own opinion on it and they can vote on it, make a determination from there. You know, the way the process is, if we don't bring something forward, it's just an automatic. What the compensation committee does. Looking through the history of the compensation commission, sometimes it gets approved what they recommend and sometimes it gets denied. The last time, actually, I think it did go through, there was no vote on it. So this is an opportunity for each commissioner to voice their opinion. You know, I don't do this job for what we get compensated, but I know there's, you know, time involved and spent. So when we evaluate what folks, you know, if they want to run for office and they're interested in what kind of pay you get, I suppose. So I guess every commissioner can have a vote, a voice on it, and we'll see where it lands up. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else? Commissioner Burry?
The notice CPD 22-14 when it comes to the federal funding. Well, they have a closeout, an adoption that they have, it has been placed in place of the CPD notice for 14-02. The new one, the CPD 22-14, is for a closeout. And it says right here, the typical statutory obligation period for the CDBG grant, a guarantee, has until the 8th federal fiscal year, after the Congress appropriates the funds to extend its annual grant unless otherwise specified in the grant agreement of the published program guidance. So what the paper is saying here is that after the 8th year and everything is done through the grant, the entitlement funding, it says here that it gives it a certain time for everything to be done when the funding comes in. Once it is done, it says right here that the funds are dispersed and allocated funds, they're dispersed to the CDBG. They're already, once they're dispersed, everything is over and said and done, and it's a closeout. You send the papers to HUD. HUD says, okay, it's over with, we do the closeout. So once the closeout is done, then we are sent, the people that are dismissed or just the mortgages, then we are sent out a 1099-C, which is for the IRS, that shows them that we have been dismissed from the mortgages. So that's part of it, the process. It's called a 1099-C, which should have been given out after 8 years of the dismissal of the mortgages that were done. They were supposed to be done after the 8 year period, once the money was dispersed, after the rehabilitation process was done. That's all I want to say.
Thank you. Commissioner Dockett, Commissioner.
Thank you. Just to the chair, to the commissioner for the third ward, could you send those documents that you have to me? I'm not familiar with what you're referring to, if you'd be so kind. Okay, can you just have those copies? Thank you, much appreciated.
You all set, Commissioner?
I am all set.
Commissioner Rivera?
Just a couple of things. One, I can think of three things that we had talked about at previous meetings that I never saw again. Breaker Cove, trash increase, and I'm just curious, I guess I just would assume they'd be put on the following agendas, but they just sort of disappear. Oh, Winona Properties, that's been gone for 2, 3, 4 months now. So I guess I'm just curious what the process is to, when items come up and we don't act on them, I'm just wondering what that is. Second item is, I've been in this business a long time. I guess I'm going to not object to the commission increases for a couple of reasons. One is, 30 years of politics, I've seen the game played where we fought against raises and cut salaries, and what it leads to is less quality people in office, right? The Michigan State Legislature now makes $8,000 less a year than I made in 1999, which means you don't have quality people running. And I understand the politics and how you try and win elections based on cutting people's salaries, but it's been my experience that it just does not add to the value of the people who are doing the job. None of us are doing this job for the money. But at the same time, I think at some point we got to stop with the politicization of these little raises for people's, the pay for these jobs. So, thank you, Madam Mayor.
Thank you, Commissioner.
I just have one last thing to say about the mortgages. there was an entity called Bay Area Housing. And so when it flipped over to that, because it was, you know, kind of affiliated with Bay City, that's why I mentioned it in my resolution. And so with me putting that in there, it back in 2014, it kind of affiliated itself with that, because once it closed down or so have you, it flipped over to the city of Bay City, and now it's called Bay Area Housing Incorporated. So when talking to people, they're mixed up here of who do they pay their mortgage to. So it's like, it kind of is to the city of Bay City, but they're not sure because it says Bay Area Housing, and then it says Bay Area Housing Incorporated. And then it says the address of Lieber 3051. So it's so mixed up with, you know, is the city of Bay City Bay Area Housing Incorporated? So it's three different places. So when I did put it on the resolution, I wanted everybody to take it in account. There were mortgages from three different entities. So I want you to take in account those three different entities that people are feeling like, you know, who is it? So please take that in account also.
You all set, Commissioner?
Yes, I am. Thank you for letting me talk.
You're welcome. With the manager's report, do you have anything to? Okay, should we talk?
I do, just a couple things. We have our neighborhood cleanup that is going to take place October 4th, 5th, and 6th. And the area is going to be bounded by 10th Street, Monroe Street, 11th Street, and Farragut Street. Burney Park is going to be our home base. And what we are going to be working on is some brush cleanup, some debris cleanup in the alleys, some porch replacements, and repairs. We do need volunteers. We're looking for some skilled labor, if we could get that. Manual labor for volunteers, for some volunteers, and we need people to help serve lunch, and also to check our volunteers in. So if anybody is interested, if businesses are interested in sending some employees, October 4th, 5th, and 6th. Please contact Angelique in our Community Development Department, and she is organizing this. And the second thing I have this afternoon, I had a Teams meeting with General Motors. They sent something, I don't know, it was like noon that they wanted to have a meeting with myself, Megan Seaman from the Chamber, Joanne Query from Saginaw Future, and one of our employees. So it was just a small group. We met with them, and they wanted just to let us know where they were at in negotiations, their last offer, which I think all of us have seen. And they shared a website because I had asked about, you know, where can we see these up-to-date negotiations? And they have a website, and it's called gmnegotiations2023.com. So you can sign on to that. I have not done that yet, but you can sign on to that and see how their negotiations are going on both sides. And to answer Commissioner Rivett's question, the breaker code presentation. Typically what we do is if a commissioner wants to bring it forward from their ask, if they just get it to me, then we can bring that forward. So we have to wait for a commissioner to ask us to do that. It's not staff initiated. The trash increase, there was a notice sent to the commission already about the fee schedule change, and that went out right after the last meeting. So that went out to the commissioners already. Winona Park Properties, we are still waiting on information. We're still waiting on information from them to get the background of some of their board members that you had requested. It's in a little bit of a hole because I think one of the board members is going to step off. So they'll get all that information and we'll get that to you as soon as I get it.
The next item is public input. This is the opportunity to come forth and talk to us about anything that you would like us to. Simon, take the name and address for the record. You'll have 5 minutes.
Dear union members, as we bargain for a new contract with McLaren, we want to express our concerns around the standards of care and the level of staffing in our hospital. Frontline nurses know firsthand how significantly short staffing has impacted patient care in our hospital. Just in the past 2 months, longer now, we've experienced 48 staffing emergencies that require nurses to shift to other floors. This staffing crisis in our hospital is handcuffing our ability to provide the quality care that our patients deserve. It's also creating physical, mental, and traumatic burdens to the staff, leading to burnout and increasing in turnover. We cannot continue to work in these overwhelming conditions. Those of us who have stayed at the clinic do it because we love our patients and we love our community. However, we need our employer to support us so we can continue to do the work that we love, and we need McLaren to step up and provide the following for the nurses. Reward longevity so we can retain our most experienced nurse healthcare workers who know and care about the hospital and the communities we live in. Retention starts with appreciating those who have given the most. Experienced staff should be rewarded and paid for their commitment to their community. Acknowledging and mitigating the mental, physical, and emotional sacrifice of working short staff. Short staffing places extra strain on long-term staff in the hospital, leading to exhaustion, burnout, and turnover. McLaren needs to both acknowledge and support our nurses who continue to take on this burden. Make McLaren Bay Ridge an attractive place to work. We cannot recruit and retain workers until McLaren lives up to the values of its community. We want McLaren to invest in the staff, the patients, and the communities where they exist. And we need to protect our patients and staff. Nurses need to feel respected and protected when they are working in environments where patients have chronic health conditions. We should be able to work freely to ensure that patients receive all the necessary care they need, while not worrying about our capacity or ability to treat our patients. These reforms are essential to ending our staffing crises and improving patient care in our facility. Sincerely, McLaren RNs. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else who would like to address
the board? Is this public?
Yes.
Sir, just write your name down and your address and say it aloud to you for our records.
Dennis Iron, 237 South Walnut Street. I live in the condos facing Vets Park, and the old tennis courts there I watched being demolished, and the city put a lot of money in for a parking lot, which doesn't get utilized. I took photos of all the events this year, and that lot did not get utilized. It would be a great place for pickleball courts. And I'm asking if there'd be some consideration, as I heard Carroll Park's project got turned down. If all the new businesses come on the west side, it'd be a nice revenue builder, and I think it'd be a very nice addition to the city. Carroll Park, on an average day, I usually go every day, there's anywhere from 30 to 55 people there. 24 people play at a time, so there's a lot of people sitting. Of course, a lot of them are driving over that way too. So, I don't know what the plans are. I know you can't understand, you can't interject anything bad. But it'd be nice if you consider it. And also the trees on the west side brought to the attention. They're dead last year, and we're still dead.
Okay, this time's public hearing. You can address the commission. Okay, the next order of business calls for public hearing. This is the opportunity for citizens to address the commission regarding public hearing items. Under the rules of the city commission, each speaker will be allowed 5 minutes to speak. Commissioner Hilliker will be the timekeeper. Is there a motion to allow for public hearing, Commissioner Drew?
Move to allow for public hearing number one, Dangerous Building, 810 Stanton Street.
Thank you. Is there a second? Commissioner Brenner?
Second.
Alrighty. So if anyone wants to talk about the public hearing, you can come to the podium and let us know what you'd like to speak on. So no one wants to come forth. And we will move on to special orders. Will the clerk please read the next item on the agenda?
Special order number one, commission as a whole resolution approving the order of dangerous building hearing officer regarding 810 Stanton Street, recommendation approved.
Is there a motion? Commissioner Hilliker?
Move to approve.
Is there a second? Commissioner Gerard?
Second.
I know I have received several calls on this building being dangerous, and I think that it's important to pass this.
Yes, thank you. Question of probably the city manager. At the last meeting, is this the address that the gentleman spoke about and wanted a couple more weeks to get things in order? Is that?
Yes, yes.
And so with this being on the agenda, does that mean that there was no follow-through on that? Or? So
there was no follow-through on it until today at 4 o'clock, and he came in and did take out a building permit. He did not take out an electrical permit. Our suggestion is still pass the resolution. In the resolution, it does give him an additional 60 days before it's demo, so that would still give him some leeway to do the other items that he needs to do. And if it doesn't take place, then we continue.
Right, and this resolution is just to convene a hearing, correct? This resolution doesn't direct anything, right?
No, it would start the demo process.
Oh, it would, okay.
Yes.
And he still would have 60 days?
Yes.
After today, tonight? Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner, Commissioner Brenner?
Actually, Commissioner Clements already asked my question, so I'm all set.
Thank you. Anything else, commissioners? Would the clerk please call the roll on the motion to approve?
Commissioner Brenner?
Yes.
Brenner?
Yes.
Hilliker?
Yes.
Gerard?
Yes.
Kuzmetsky?
Yes.
Clements?
Yes.
Morris?
No.
Dockett?
Yes.
Yeah.
Hey, yes, one though. The motion is approved. The next item, please.
As part of the agenda, item one, determination of salaries of city elected officials by the Compensation Commission, 9/7/23.
Is there a motion?
Is this a resolution or is this the actual item on the agenda?
This is the one on the agenda, so you'd be moving to receive it if you want to accept the increase.
Move to receive.
To receive. Commissioner Clements?
Second.
All right. Is there any discussion? Commissioner Brown?
So if it passes, then it's mute when I present it?
We would still take up yours because it would be received unless yours prevailed with 6 to reject it.
Okay.
I objected. Just had the old cousin up, correct?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So a yes vote means that you agree to receive it, a no vote means that you do not. Commissioner Broder.
First of all, I'd like some clarification. Should I move to approve or receive this?
No, you're just receiving it.
Just receive, okay.
Usually receiving it doesn't need a vote.
If I vote no, it's to push Commissioner Gerard's objection down?
No. If you still would like to receive it and have the salary increase go through, you vote yes, because the motion was to receive. So you'd like to receive. We're still going to vote on his resolution. It would take 6 to overturn what you're voting on right now.
Okay. Yes.
You kind of answered it there. So if this passes, then his resolution has to have 6 votes to overturn this.
Yes.
And if this doesn't pass, then we don't even have to take up his resolution? Is that?
Technically correct. Well, no, because
it's on the agenda, we probably.
Right. There's a motion to receive it on the floor.
Okay, thanks. I'm good.
Okay. So, Commissioner Hilliker?
Yes.
Gerard?
No.
Ms. Vesey?
We were asked to make comments on that, so we don't get to, but we get to make them on Chris's.
Yes.
Okay.
No. Hovitz.
Yes.
Morris.
Yes.
Dockett.
Yes.
Rivet.
Yes.
Rennie.
Yes.
7 yes, 2 no. So the item has been received. So the next item of business is Commissioner Charnock's resolution. Do you want it read again, or is everybody all set?
With respect to what everybody said in favor of the Compensation Committee's recommendation, I do want to make a statement as to why I'm going to cast the vote I'm casting. And this is not against anybody or their job performance. Sadly, our city, state, and nation are facing labor shortages across the board with not much relief in sight. Even more tragic is our community's recent losses to fire in 2023. The structure fire, whether it be residential, commercial, devastates the entire community, the person or family directly impacted, but also the neighbors who know and love that family. It's a lifetime loss, especially when a heart stops beating. Unfortunately, there is another elite segment of our community who also suffer from these events, our first responders. They carry each incident with them for life, long after they leave the job. The images, smells, and nightmares replay in their hearts and minds repeatedly. But what could I have done different? Did I do enough? Those family losses are our first responders' losses. When our staffing runs thin, so does their strength, both physical and mental. We have workers performing cross jobs throughout the city. It's common practice for our sanitation department, parks, water, police, and fire. Our frontline workers are approaching the breaking point. Mental and physical exhaustion, lower than they deserve pay, yet they keep showing up. I'd like Bay City to reevaluate our hiring, compensation, and replacement processes. When we have someone quit or retire in this building, we need to honestly ask if that position really needs to be filled, or would those financial resources be better served in a critical needs position, like our understaffed public safety department. I see 9 people here, including myself, who if we waived their salary could fund a firefighter for 1 year or raise up wages to incentivize more people to to apply for our open positions. These are the financial moves that should be made. I am against any increases in pay for our commission seats. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Seeing no one. Discuss for discussion. Please call the roll.
Is everybody understanding? Okay, so a yes vote means that you agree with Commissioner Gerard's resolution to reject the salary increase. A no vote means you do not. Okay. Commissioner Hooker?
No.
Hilliger?
No.
Gerard?
Yes.
Kozetsky?
Yes.
Clements?
No.
Morris?
No.
Dockett?
No.
I'm sorry?
No.
Thank you. Rivet?
No.
Bernie?
No.
So 2 yes, 7 no.
The motion is adopted. Thank you.
Commissioner Bernie's resolution?
I'd like to talk about it on the road.
Is there a moving motion? Commissioner Hilliger?
Move to approve.
Is there a second?
Second.
Commissioner Bernie?
Second.
Thank you. Is there any discussion?
Okay, what I'm asking for people need their homes. I'm not saying just give them something for free. Our community needs to be built up. A lot of the neighborhoods, they're really looking bad. And the CDBG money, that is for rehabilitation, to bring our neighborhoods up, for our economic development, for our areas. And it's making everyone's houses go down. When they appraise our homes, the neighborhoods are going down. The value of my houses went down considerably. If we use that money right and do repairs on the homes, and not put such a steep mortgage on those homes, we can put it together. But putting a 20-year mortgage on a furnace and putting 20 years on a person's home isn't feasible. It is excessive. There's no way for a low-income person to get out from underneath that. They lose their homes to the city. It's not fair. If we're trying to rehabilitate and fix our neighborhoods, the lower to moderate income neighborhoods. In the same token, we are making the other houses, how can I put it? We're building up the price of homes. If you want to sell your home, it's going to sell for a lot more money. But if you're trying to buy a home in a broken down neighborhood, you're stuck. Nobody wants to live in that neighborhood. You are stuck with that home. But in the same token, 20 years on a, like I said, a furnace or repair of a roof to someone that is a low-income family is just not feasible. If we could just, with the CDBG money, after 8 years, that falls off. We need to follow protocol. We need to. And I'm asking, those mortgages that have been on homes for 20 years, they need to be let go. If the government says 8 years, then let's follow that. We need to. We don't need to be assessive. The government said it's assessive. Development said they're going to change it. They had 90 days to do that. I haven't seen anything. So please think about it. It's only fair. 20 years, you die. Your kids don't get your home. They don't get it. They don't get to sit in front of the fireplace. We don't get to tell them stories. The city has it. So just think about that.
Commissioner Clements?
Yes, thank you. heard of this until Commissioner Burney started talking about it. And then the other thing too that, you know, is talking about where you pay your mortgage, and she mentioned LIBOR 3051, that's not an address, that's like a book in the Register of Deeds office. So, you know, if I was gonna vote tonight, it'd be no, but I guess, you know, if we refer this back to staff to get some